probably you all know about this. It's the ocean plastic that is a big problem. About a truckload of more plastic is dumped into the oceans every single minute. Some estimate that by 2050, there is more plastic than fish in the oceans. So we must start collecting this plastic. But what to do with this collected material that is a dirty mixture of different plastics? This is a challenge for the existing recycling technologies. I propose biotechnology to tackle this problem. Living microbial cells, like this bacterium, to process the collected plastic. But how? I will explain it to you. So bacteria have learned to eat different kind of stuff. Almost whatever is available in the nature. Now the question is, whether there is already a bacterium that eats plastic? Actually, yes, like this one. So this bug was isolated from a plastic recycling plant in Japan. It eats PET plastic, so basically soft drink bottles. So when this bacterium eats plastics, it converts the carbon in the plastic into its own biomass. So what is this bacterial biomass then? It's mainly protein. Think about this. What if we would grow this bacterium in a closed bioreactor by feeding plastic in? So this way, we could convert the plastic into protein, right? But here's the problem. So this bacterium eats plastic very slowly. And this I want to change. So first, I want to search new microbes that eat different kind of plastics. And this work we have already started in our team. Next, I want to improve them. I want to boost the evolution to get fast plastic-eating microbes. And how to do this? Have you heard about synthetic biology, including technologies like CRISPR genome editing and directed evolution in the lab? Totally disruptive technologies. I want to use them and improve these microbes. And when we have these improved microbes, we could do this. Collected plastic, it's converted into protein in a closed bioreactor. And this protein could be used as a fish food somewhere far away on a Pacific island. Thanks.
Right. Thank you, Joosu. That sounds like an amazing project. Who would have thought that plastic could become food for fish?
Yeah.
Anne Toppinen, do you have a question for Joosu?
Thank you, Joosu, for a really inspiring pitch. Research is always done in collaboration with different disciplines. So can you maybe mention three collaborative avenues? If you get this funding, where would you start looking for collaboration?
Yes. Well, of course, collecting this plastic from oceans and technology around that, that's really important. That's one. Then it's not only biology. Maybe this plastic needs some kind of pre-treatment before bioprocess step. So that's also one. And of course, then the end product. If it's protein, food, or feed, also we need experts for that as well.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anne, and thank you, Joosu.